So, I am the only company in the world who was being tested scientifically to know what happens in your brain when you have an extraterrestrial relationship. The University of Illinois, to the Dr. Norman Dunn, decided to, for the first time in history, do a test with contactees or abductees and see what happened with these people at the moment they had the chance to be in touch with alien entities. So they select 120 people and they submit these people to a reading to electrodes in your brain for a computer and check how your brain works in normal times and what happens when you are able to connect with extraterrestrial beings. Okay, they did with 120 people. The results of this test was presented in 1993 in an international UFO conference in Brazil. And they selected only two cases. One, this girl was presenting a paranormal phenomenon, manifestations in her body. And the second one was mine. Why? Because they were able to see clearly what means altered states of mind when you establish a contact with extraterrestrial beings. So they were able to register in the frontal lobes that we are able to reach instantly over 40 megahertz of frequency immediately. Something that not only is uncommon in the human brain, but it's also being reached only in some special cases of people who was being trained their whole life in special states of mind. That's it. So they were able to identify that extraterrestrial beings are changing our world. This is an atomic conclusion. So even with all these cases of abductions, all these cases of contacts, the people who were in this kind of experience, they came back changed. For better. So the extraterrestrial beings clearly are showing that not only they're studying the human being, but also they are preparing the human being for something special. We need to understand that there's a lot of discussion in regards to what's their intentions, what they are looking for, they're going to invade us, they're going to take control, are we going to be the next menu, who knows, right? It is clear that if we're still alive, their intentions are good. Because totally aside of Independence Day movie and so a lot others in the same way, if the extraterrestrials they decided to eliminate the human beings, they don't need to use a ray gun or destroy everything and do all this kind of stuff. It's just put a little bacteria, a virus, having already a specific DNA to work with in an atmosphere. In 24 hours, the human race was history. All the planet is still the same, nothing changed. All the animal kingdom is going to applaud the extraterrestrials because you're free. And extraterrestrials will be able to come to spend vacations in Disney World. So, this is exactly the reality. The reality is that extraterrestrials at this point, they need to identify if we are potential allies or potential enemies. Check it out on the wall this morning. Who knows what's going to be tomorrow? Mr. Trump is going to decide to push the button with North Korea. The Muslim is going to take control of the world. If what you can see in the future, in the near future, here in Norway, we're having a lot of problems with the immigrants. Not only you, UK, Switzerland, a lot of countries, Germany, all these countries are facing a huge problem right now. People from a different culture is coming. It doesn't matter to be racist. It's a matter to be realistic. You're having people with a very low background, no education, don't speak the language, with a completely different culture, vision, beliefs, values, coming to Europe, and they're trying to have control of the country, making everybody Muslims. We have a humongous cultural shock at this moment in the world. And how is it going to end? That's the question. How is it going to end? A lot of people all over the world ask me, Veronica, why do you want to learn? Why do you want to come here? And I ask you to them, where? Where are they going to land? Washington? Russia? Where? Because at the moment they're going to land somewhere, everybody's going to say, oh, they choose this place because they agree with this kind of politics or this way of living or this kind of beliefs or this kind of values. That's the problem. For them, it's a humongous problem. They can't believe in the human being. They can't believe, trust in the human race. How they know if the moment you're going to turn around, somebody is going to stop them just to take hold of the technology? And tomorrow probably we're Muslims. So, it's like I say, oh, Hitler, he had influence from the extraterrestrials and they were helping him at that time to develop this incredible technology. If that were true, we were speaking German right now. Forget it. No way. It's not possible to be another way. So the extraterrestrials were in a very tight situation. They're thinking, what do we do? We know that the human being at some point is going to reach space. We are going to need to face them now or who knows in the future. And what are we going to do with it? Are we going to open our arms and give the chance to come and be part of this universal society or not? And this is exactly the point. How are we going to be able to trust the human being? How are we going to be able to open our arms and share who we are and what we are? Outside, there's a federation of planets, as we can say. There's no Spock, there's no Kirk, but it's already an organization. Like United Nations here. Same thing. Why? Because sometimes all over the millennium, few civilizations, they cross routes and say, oh, how are you? Oh, yeah, how are you? And they decided to exchange knowledge, information, and technology because their values, their principles, they were common. So, and they decided, at some point, to work together. For what? Simple. They want to keep the universe outside in peace, in harmony, respecting each other, and live in this way. So what they're doing outside, in fact, is a policement work. They're trying to know the neighbors, they're trying to see who is already developing technology, who potentially will be a good neighbor or a bad neighbor. When they're seeing that this kind of neighbor is not following a very nice path, what they're going to do? Knock your door and sir, you're not alone here. And we want you to respect the principles, the order, the laws of this condo. If you don't want to do that, let us know. Because at that point, they're going to take measures for that. So if until now they're still alive, it's because they're seeing hope in our future. That's the real thing. You can say, oh, our brothers and sisters, extraterrestrials, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, beautiful, very romantic. But extraterrestrials are not stupid. Took for them thousands of years, to reach what they have today. They don't have misery, they don't have violence, they don't have differences, they don't need to fight to get a job, they don't need to fight to have recognition, they don't need to suffer anything. And they're going to allow a bunch of kids to miss out that harmony? Nobody will say. No, they're not going to do it. So what they're going to do is simple. They're going to knock our doors several times at the point that they're going to let us know that we're not alone, there's somebody there, they are shaking us, and they're testing us. So the human race is already under a test. We are right now under the surveillance. And what they are doing right now is giving things to the human race and see what we do with it. Oh, yeah, this lady, she was already being pregnant from an extraterrestrial. Now she's going to conceive a hybrid, blah, 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 the whole thing. Wait a minute. They're going to get a woman pregnant. They're going to study her for 3-4 months. And after that, they're going to take the fetus out. Excuse me. These guys, they're able to bend the space-time continuum, the universe, and travel thousands of light years to this planet. They never heard about a dolly or something like that. They didn't know about having, in this case, a genetic development in vitros or something like that. Excuse me. How childish the human being can be to be so scared, so afraid of what they don't know, that they can get whatever kind of mad idea and believe it. And believe it. How are you going to test how mature somebody is if you give to this person an information, an event, and see how he's going to understand or even analyze the whole thing? So you can see, oh, there's somebody say, oh, the extraterrestrials, they're going to invade us. The invasion already started. They want to invade us for what? What are they going to get? A lot of head expressions. But that's it. What are they going to get from us? What are they going to get they don't have at this point? Nothing. Only 2 billion people to feed. That's it. And what else? Oh, they're going Excuse me? This civilization, they have thousands of years of existence. Do you think that they don't know a lot of stuff? And they need to do it all over and all over and all over? Like we saw yesterday, how many abductions per day they can have? We got their worried. So they're doing this because they need to have something to do, right? This is exactly the test. The test is seeing things coming. Oh, we have already here Dr. blah blah blah, and he's going to talk about abductions, or you can be the next victim. Be careful. Beware. Excuse me? We're talking about civilizations extremely advanced. Extremely advanced. Advanced in every single thing you can imagine. And you're going to consider that they need us to learn something more? Simple. Okay, we're going to adopt somebody already here, and okay, we're going to put a lot of experiments inside. No. Why the abduct people? Yeah, the abductions are real, for sure. This is not in that number. And why the abduct people? Simple. They need to know how we are evolving. So they take somebody in your family long time ago. They did some enhancements. And now what they're going to do, you're going to do the follow-up. You know how long these people live? You have an idea? 4,000 years. 4,000 years. So this means the guy I'm in contact to, he had the chance to shake hands with Abraham and Noah and who knows who. 4,000 years. So, what are you doing? Simple. We're going to follow up the genetic development of this family and see how these enhancements we put in the DNA are already growing, developing, and becoming something that we're going to be able to use in the future for something better. This is what they're doing. That's the reason why they didn't land yet. Because we're not ready. We're not ready. We are so diverse, so incredibly diverse, that we are not trustworthy. That's the problem. What's the difference between you and me? They know me. For 43 years, they were following me. I was able to do, my God, experiences, contacts, bringing this to the rest of 300 people. And that's why I didn't go. 300 people. And I'm not talking about a little brain. I'm talking a guy 6 meters tall. You have an idea what means that? 6 meters tall. We're walking among the cars coming here. Yeah, yeah. I have more than 300 people seeing me disappeared from nothing and appear from nothing. So this is the type of complex we have. So we're talking, oh yeah, UFOs, yeah, the military, yeah, about this, yeah. They are far away, lost in the past. Today, the reality is completely different. They are coming. They are here. Absolutely. But to whom they are going to talk? The ones they are going to trust. This is exactly how it's going to be. So for 43 years, I have already presidents of different countries. I am Canadian. I have my citizenship. My citizenship took 5 years to be able to have. Why? Because the immigration department have a file this big about it. why we allow me to have a citizenship? More clear. They want to know what I'm going to do. They want to know how far I'm going to go. We talked to the United Nations 3 times. You never hear about it, right?
Yeah.
We talked to the United Nations 3 times in regards to our experiences and what our friends upstairs are looking for. In 1997, the United Nations has a meeting, 3 meetings in total, where some astronauts came also in the middle, looking for creation of an agency, a worldwide agency, to look for the UFO phenomenon. This means work together, all nations, to be able to understand and establish a relationship with extraterrestrial beings. How about the first one to deny the motion was the United States. And at the end, unfortunately, nothing happened. This is exactly the situation today. When we're talking about culture things, what are you going to do? How are you going to come? At the moment you're going to come here, how are you going to accept that knowledge, that presence, that information, that content? How? Our beliefs are not their beliefs. Their societies are not like ours. The structure of this society is completely different than ours. Are we going to accept that? Are we going to be able to incorporate that kind of experience to us? Check it out. If you give a kiss to somebody, or another, a girl or a guy in the middle of the Middle Eastern country, they want to go to jail. Today, 2017, you can see in Russian television in Iran, and you're going to see a TV show how to hit your wife if she's not doing what you want. That's not a joke, it's real. There was a TV show in Iran discussing if women are human beings. Do you believe that? 2017, and we have that. How they are going to free the extraterrestrials? Excuse me. With immigration in a company I used to work, they have a lot of Muslims, immigrants. They had a protest with the human resources. They didn't accept a woman as a manager. They refused to work. They will accept only having a man as a manager. 2017, first world country, Canada. Well, Merkel, Prime Minister of Germany, not too long ago, said on television, the immigration program failed completely. She had 45,000 police reports in regards to problems and trouble with immigrants in Germany. How is it going to be now? How is it going to be Europe with millions of immigrants right now coming here, fighting with you and trying to play the Sharia in your countries? So check it out, the difficulty of the extraterrestrials right now. What are you going to do? No matter what, no matter how, the human beings are going to get in touch with extraterrestrial beings for sure. But what? Are they going to wait until we'll kill each other and define who's going to survive? Or they're going to do something else before? That's the big question. And this is exactly our reality. Yeah, we are worrying nuclear war from North Korea. But at the same time, we have something else, different things happening around. Today, you are ending your participation in this event. You are hearing about extraterrestrials, you're having a lot of information, what the army or the military knows, what is happening here, what's happening there. And how is going to be your day after? What are you going to do? You are going to another event, another bunch of lectures, another bunch of people telling a lot of stuff. Oh yeah, ooh, nice, ooh, incredible, yeah. And after that, to another bunch of lectures, to another bunch of lectures, and so on. What are you going to do? The world is still the same. So in fact, you are sitting down and waiting for the definition of our existence. Then tell me what you're going to do. What is going to happen tomorrow? What is going to be tomorrow? In 1993, I wrote a book. I gave you the link in the internet. It's a free access. And there's a big part, 7 pages. The extraterrestrials told me about the future until 2016. This information was given to me in 1974. And until 2016, nothing changed. Everything was already in that book, been happening like a clock. Point by point. I have a lot of websites in the internet who took parts of my book and they're published also. But this sad. It's really sad. That over 43 years, nothing, that information changed. So that means in 43 years, the human being didn't change a bit. So, are we going to change someday? Or are we going to be forced to change someday? Right now, all over all these years, the whole situation in our planet has been getting worse and worse. You have change of prayers, change of good thoughts, chain of meditation all over the world. And this is happening for a while, not now. Is it working? Have been working. The world is better. We have more hope. We have more opportunities, more chances, better scenarios, a beautiful horizon. How you are living your lives, You're living your life in a way to look for a light at the end of the tunnel. You're not living, you're surviving. And you're trying to lie to yourself, saying that somebody at some point is going to be the new guru, the new messiah, the changer, the one who's going to make everything be better. All these are terrestrials. There's a lot of people who are looking right now, they lost faith and religion and whatever, that they are having faith in extraterrestrials to change the world. They are thinking that the extraterrestrials are going to park over here on the side and say, who's the next to go? And this is the way you're going to be taken from this planet. Go straight forward to their planet, and that's going to be paradise. No way! Are you kidding? Are you going to take us and take us to their planet? My God! Are you going to play the shali over there? That's it! This is the reality. This is the situation right now. Extraterrestrials are for real. That's not a joke. They're for real. You need to know exactly who we are. We are on her side, or their side, or against. Right now we don't know who we can trust here in our planet. So imagine a little. They've been racial for a long time. They have been choosing people all over the world to understand the human being. In 1974, my brother and I, we were in this incredible experience, having a lot of contacts, physical experience, and a lot of stuff. My brother had contact with Orion beings, humanoid. And I started to have my contacts with people from Alpha Centauri. And in some way, our experiences started to become a little bit different in how we were understanding the information they were giving. So at some point, he told us, this is an experiment. We want to know what happens with a human being when he is able to access not only the experience in fact, contact, see them, be with them, but also live with them and see how this is going to end. Yep. We have the chance to be there. Live with them for a while. Know how they live. Know how they think. Know how their societies work. So we have that chance. And we came back excited to be able to see in what way we're able to find people capable to be changers. This is exactly what we're looking for. This is exactly what they are looking for. Who is going to be the next changer? Who's going to be able to change minds? Who's going to be able to produce and make transformations? Who's going to be able to impact the other people's lives in a good way, in an incredible way? Not only opening their minds, not only opening their eyes in regards to life. What incredible beings! What incredible beings! We are here, right now, with a mind to think. Check it out this way. What's the purpose of the intelligent being exist in this universe? Now, what? What's the purpose of the intelligent being exist in the universe?
Learning.
Okay. And you understand and see the cost of that? Because in whatever kind of process of learning, you have the attempt and you have the error. A lot of errors some way. Why take the risk? Why take the risk? If the purpose of creation was peace, harmony, balance, the only thing that would be missing in the creation was intelligent being. Everything else will be perfect. Why? Animals, they don't have any kind of problems. They cannot be blamed. They are instinctive. All what they do is exactly what nature claims to do. So they don't feel guilt if they need to kill to survive. They don't have any kind of consciousness problems in regards to what they need to do. So if we're looking for balance, harmony, absolute peace, everything in the right place, the whole environment, in order, the only figure you're going to pick out is the intelligent being. But we're here, right now. Why?
Have experience.
Sorry?
Have experience.
Experience what? Can you imagine that the cost of a creature trying and trying and trying, every time this creature tries, puts in jeopardy a huge balance? This is exactly what we're doing right now. So this is exactly what happened. When we have a creature like us who's going to learn how to see, understand, be things, we're going to jeopardize a lot of stuff. The problem is when you're stubborn, when you try, and you're not able to see if this is for good or for bad. And this is exactly the problem right now. We don't have that kind of clarity. We don't have that kind of perception. We're not able to see, in fact, what are we doing? Because we don't understand the connection everything has in the universe. We don't see how things are related, how things are connected. In what way, when we put something here, there's a lot of stuff that is going to change. We don't have that kind of perception. We don't care about this perception. We're looking for results now, here. And we don't care that something else in the long run is going to be destroyed. And this is what we were doing generation after generation and so on in our history. But you're already doing. How far you go, worse is going to be the book. And this is the point we are here now. Now is the time to pay the bill. Now is the time where we're going to face the consequences of our human existence. We are the generation of the end of the world, as you know. Yep. Like it or not, somebody should come and pay the bill. This is us. We are here right now, in a moment where the universe outside is going to come and give us the bill. What are we going to do? How are we going to react in front of that? Are we going to wait for the extraterrestrials to help us and say, please, I'm going to be good tomorrow? How are we going to be? What are we going to do? How is going to be our relation with these creatures? This is actually the biggest point right now with them. For 43 years, I have been taking people to the field, be able to see extraterrestrials physically the way I'm with you right now. Not spiritual experiences, dimensional experiences, mental channeling. Having the God in front of you. Having the ship already here in front of you. 43 years doing that. 43 close and conquest of the third kind.
Where are they?
Where is my group? The people who started with me. The people who went to the same places in 1974, seeing these wonders, having these incredible experiences.
Where are they? They're lost.
Like every single human being.
Why?
Because they don't have the guts. Simple. Are you going to expose yourself to tell what you saw, what you believe, what you understand? Are you going to jeopardize your job? Are you going to jeopardize who you are? Are you going to jeopardize your family? Are you going to jeopardize your patience or your life in some way? Oh, you have an idea what I have been facing for 43 years. I have military, I have police, I have different agencies knocking my door several times in different countries, for sure. Are you going to be afraid of continue? Oh yeah, for sure. A lot of people do. All these people who have all these incredible experiences, they were not capable to exchange their lives for that future. Because they know that someone, somebody, in some time, will be able to do what they're not capable to. This is the human being. The human being is an incredible lazy guy who don't want to dirty his hands and is waiting for somebody to take that step. After 43 years, it's still the same. So, as a contactee, prime contactee, having the chance to bring people to the field, an incredible experience you can ever imagine in your wildest dreams. What do you think about the human race? It's terrible. It's sad. It's sad. We have an incredible chance, an incredible opportunity. The universe has opened their arms for us. And what are we doing? The same thing we did all over our history. Nothing. Absolutely nothing. How many people are capable to face adversity, difficulties, danger? For his human fellow. How many people loves the human being? How many people loves our planet? How many people loves our future? How many people loves life? Unfortunately, not too many. Not too many. And this is sad. Because if you're looking for a better world, as we have in the lecture in the beginning, who wants change? We all want change. But who's willing to change? I don't know. So that's the problem. You want contact with extraterrestrial beings? Easy. The problem is, do they want to contact you? That's a different question. So this is very important. Contact them? Oh yeah, no problem at all. Let's go to the day, let's go outside, go to the field, look in the sky. Perfect, no problem at all. But, do they want you? For what? To kill your curiosity? To let you know, yeah, we exist, we're here? Or to let you know, yeah, and how's it going to be the day after? What are you going to do? Are you going to try something else, something different? over this long walk for the world in 43 years, my God, having seen crazy things. There's people who came to me, oh, yeah, I have an experience, you know. They contact me sometimes. Oh, yeah, I know his brother, his sister, his mother-in-law. I know everybody in his family. He allowed me to visit his house.
Okay.
What is transcendent in that? What is the purpose of an extraterrestrial being to contact you, to just provide you nonsense information? We're talking about creatures that live thousands of light years away. People who have an incredible civilization and incredible development. What are you going to exchange? Imagine. What are you going to do? You have an extraterrestrial in front of you right now. What are you going to do?
Yeah.
What else are you going to do? What else? Long time ago, I have a guy who was part of my brother's group in Chile, and he called me and he said, Veronica, I'm already 8 years working with Cisco, blah, 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 and we need something more. We need something that is going to make our group become stronger and something like that, okay? And I went to Chile to talk to him in his room. We were talking, I stayed there for 2 weeks. And 2 weeks after that, he went to the field with his group. And suddenly, they started to see footsteps, very strong footsteps, coming towards them. And a 2 meters high, tall guy, long hair, started to come in his direction. He was getting closer. At one point, he said, please stop. I cannot handle this. I'm not ready for this. He turned around and disappeared. All the other members of the group saw that. 8 years, looking for something, planning for something, and when it happens, what do you do? And this is not one single story. This is a story of many other people, many other things all over the world. When things like this happen, when you have the real McCoy in front of you, you're not able to handle. Why? Because at this moment, everything what you believe changes. How's your religion? How's going to be your life? How's going to be your beliefs? How's going to be your way of living? How's going to be out there? Ooh, sure, it's going to change a lot. The extraterrestrial, they did something interesting with me. I had the chance not only to see them, not only to talk to them, not only to live with them. And then I was asking, you know why? Because even all these years, when I see the human beings so terribly ignorant, sometimes giving the wish or the desire to give up and let the world blow up by itself. But why not doing that? Because what I was able to see. Because what I was able to learn. One day, I was there with them, and came the moment to come back to planet Earth. And my friend, my extraterrestrial friend, came to me and said, do you want to stay? Do you want to stay here with us? And I looked at him, and I started to think, all the faces I know, all the people I know, and think what is going to happen and how the future is going to be. And think that they don't have a clue. They don't know. they can even imagine the kind of life these people have. Be there, stay there, live this incredible paradise, knowing that here, there's a lot of people suffering, a lot of people wishing, a lot of people looking for a better day. I said to him, I will not be able to sleep every single night here, knowing that there's a lot of people down there looking for hope. And he decided to come back. And this is an excellent point. You don't have a clue about our future, what is going to happen, and what options, what chances do we have. Can you imagine how it will be to have a planet, a world, a civilization capable to be open arms, to take what they are willing to give to us for free, and be able to renounce to what we believe for what we have right now in exchange for something absolutely better? Are we able to have the courage to face that transition? Are we able to face this new world completely different, where there's no differences between people, where there's no difference between beliefs, where the value is only one, peace? Being harmony. Have exactly what we need. Have exactly what we are looking for. Family. But this is the problem. The human being is an interesting creature. Yeah, nice, wonderful, absolutely. But you have the courage to take it. As Grandma Corso said, right? Are you able to take it? Are you willing to? Are you able to fight for a better world? And when do you be able to face whatever kind of consequences in regards to a fair civilization? 2,000 years ago, somebody who tried to do something different died on the cross. Are you willing to do the same? What would happen if he decides to come back again? He will end in the cross again? How? What is going to be the world 2,000 years after? Better? Fair? Intelligent enough to understand, spiritual enough to be able to love, how's it going to be? We're creatures here with this capability. Why the intelligence exists? Why the intelligence exists? To what? To be happy. To live happy. To have a fair life, to respect, to understand, to comprehend, to be able to provide, to be able to help, to be able to give. That is why we have a brain and we think. Our intelligence exists exactly to provide the sources, the resources, the tools, the elements necessary to build that, not to make mistakes, but to build a future. And we're using for what? To kill each other. Find better ways, more sophisticated ways to submit, to enslave, to kill, to destroy, to compete, but not to what? I'm going to show you how the moon takes. Interesting, right? Are we getting into the twilight zone? This is the answer. When we'll have consideration, peace, harmony, respect for our fellow human beings and for the environment, finally, we will have proven to the universe that here really exists intelligent life. Until then, no. So this is exactly the point. This is the clue. This is something what we need to look in for. Prove to the universe outside that we are worthy. Not only to be part of this universe, but to be considered. Not only part of this incredible universal mind, but also to get from them a possible future. Because until then, we don't have future. We have only uncertainty, fear, suffering, and an incredible time to adjust, define if we're going to survive or not. Ladies and gentlemen, I expect that what I was able to provide to you, give you a clue, give you a guide, become a light on the end of the tunnel. They are outside waiting for each one of you, looking for the possibility not only to trust you, but to put in your hands the future of this planet, the future of the human being. Because remember, it's not only you. What about your kids and their kids? How is it going to be the future of all of them? You are the one right now having the chance to create a path, to create a way, to create a horizon for all of them, for all the children in the world, for all the kids who exist, who are going to become to exist. So think that carefully, deeply. There's no immortality, or better immortality in life. They continue to exist in the mind of those who gratefully remembers you, who gratefully remembers your efforts, your life towards a better world. This is the way you want to be immortal, being remembered in the hearts, in the minds of all of who at that moment have to change life, have their lives changed completely thanks to you. So in each moment in their lives will be an instant when you're going to be grateful for what you did. So for what you were able to live for them, for what you're able to, in some way, create or build to them. Thank you so much.
Ok, on va pas projeter rien.
Viens. Yeah. Je vais voir, on me lève.
Peut-être qu'il y a un manager avec nous, mais c'est pas grave, on va inscrire tard, on va voir ce que c'est. Mmh.
What? just knowledge. All the possible knowledge existing in him. But is this knowledge manifesting? Is this knowledge being tested? If this knowledge is having movement, no. This knowledge stops within him. That's it. So God, or this power, at the moment he was just him, was stuck. No movement, no test is the knowledge within. In order to evolve and test himself and test the knowledge, he needs to have a dynamic. They need to have movement. They need to have action. And where this action will be able to be? In a scenario, in a place where all this knowledge will be able to start and run and test itself. This is who we are. We are creation. We are the extension of this power. We are the place, the scenario, where all this knowledge is working. So us, we, intelligent beings, we are the extensions of this knowledge. Being able to report to this power what we are doing. So what's the soul? The soul is exactly this element that connect the physical universe to this spiritual level. So through the soul, we're able to report our existence, our experiences, our knowledge, how we are in some way acting in this scenario. And this power, or this God, will be able to receive from us a feedback. So we are completing God. That's the reason why we exist. That's the reason we have a soul. That's the reason we are able to participate in this incredible universe. And this is why the soul is immortal. Because the soul don't belong to the physical universe. It's just an interface. We have a laptop. We have the interface connected to the internet, to God. And this is how everything works. So God needs to give us free will. Why? Because this is the way we're going to do a lot of mistakes. This is the way we're going to mess up the whole thing. Because we don't have a pre-existing behavior. We're going to create the path to know how to behave. And this is how creation is going to be. So creation, in fact, is not just what we have. It's more than that. Imagine. We have the capability to see the future. We have the capability to have to see an event that is going to happen, who knows when, and happen. Oops. So you were able to see something that didn't happen yet? How? How are you going to be able to receive inputs or information in regards to an event that is not happening yet? All this information needs to come from somewhere. All these images need to come from somewhere. Where is this? Where is the place where this information is coming to us? When? So if we're able to see the future, this means this event we're seeing right now exists somewhere. But where? not now, because it didn't happen now, but it's going to be happening somewhere. Wait. Why we have the capability to be able to see the future? What's the meaning of that? Why? Why do we need to know the future? In what way we need to have to access this kind of information? If we are here, and this is a time level, and we're able to see something that is in a different time level, what is connecting us? So this means the idea of a soul or creation I have in my mind is not exactly that way. So this means my soul is also existing in a different place. And what we all, and what we I consider already an extra paranormal perception is what my other soul is witnessing. For me, it's going to be my future, but for my other soul, is his presence. How this works? So this means that creation is not working in a simple level, but multiple. So the soul is not just a single, simple energy, but multiple. All of them being part of different space-time dimensions. Simple. Let's not think this way. Well, we believe in reincarnation, right? Okay, nice. How was the purpose to reincarnate? The purpose of reincarnation is to learn and have karma and be able to learn the next step, blah, blah, blah. Okay. You're living here in Norway. How long? 60, 70, 80 years. In this lifetime, what you were able to learn? Because of this exact moment, there's a lot of stuff happening in North Korea, United States, South America, Russia, whatever. Are you able to be part of that? No. So that means that this incarnation level didn't give you too much. And it's not going to happen again. Because at the moment you're going to reincarnate, the next time, this time moment or this time frame will never happen again. So you will not be able to have all the knowledge that this time frame could be able to do or give it to you. What a waste. Right? So, it is possible to consider that the reason why our soul is multiple is because all the other souls are part in this all possibilities in the same time frame. So yeah, that would be giving sense to reincarnation. So the moment all of them die, they come together, they digest all this incredible information, sending this information to the source, and get ready to a new life. And then multiple universes and space-time. So this is how it works. The universe and creation development is incredible, huge. Why? We go because we are children of God. And God needs us. That's the reason why we're here. That's the reason why we're part of this incredible thing. We're stopping everything, yeah, for sure, but at the same time, we're making him sense. We're giving him the chance to also evolve. Our movement here completes him. That's the reason why we have this incredible relationship is more than important, because we are giving to this power sense, meaning, purpose. So that's extremely important about who we are. We are here not only just to change our future. We're going to be capable to change the future of other civilizations in the future. At the moment, we're going to be integrated to these civilizations outside. We're going to be able to continue their work through us in different places. So imagine how great, how incredible, how beautiful life is, or can be. If we have time, if we have patience, if we have peace to be able to search for all these incredible possibilities. This is what exists outside, waiting for us. These creatures are totally willing to share their knowledge, totally willing to show what they were able to conquer over time. They are totally friendly. They are here exactly to keep and maintain the peace and the harmony of the universe outside. And they are just waiting for us to make a decision. Are we going to go, or are we going to stay? Questions? That's it?
Thank you, Veronica, for a very good lecture. Very interesting.
Thank you.
A friend of mine, a Swedish contactee, by the way, whose books I have for sale outside, he tells that information he has got it in other planets, other dimensions, and so there is only one, if we should call it race or species, on each planet. And the big reason why there is so much problem on Earth is because we have got the whites, we've got the blacks, we've got the yellows, we've got the reds. Is that something that you have learned from that?
We're the salad. We're the salad. Not in the English. Second reason why. Doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. In some way, diversity becomes an incredible school. Because it's what, if we are able to find the same horizon, the same goals, the same objectives, even in this diversity, we conquer a lot. And we are incredible, able to evolve in a different way. Imagine, you have somebody in the first floor in a building, and you ask for help. What do you see through the window? Oh, not a building. Okay. Go to the fifth floor. What do you see? Oh, yeah. I saw this building, but there's another door behind. Okay, go to the 10th floor. Oh, I'm able to see the rise and the sun over there. Wonderful. This is exactly how we are. Who's right? Who has the truth? Everybody. Because it depends on what window in that building you are. So when we are exchanging, the human nature gives us the stupid idea that we have the truth and we're able to handle it, when in fact we have only one window, not all of them. And this is exactly what we need to do. We need to be humble. We need to be extremely humble and recognize that we are not everywhere at the same time. And be able to accept, we only take what somebody else can give us as a new knowledge. Thank you for your patience.
I have one question for you.
Oh, yeah.
You had a renewed contact with Gola last year.
Yeah.
Okay. And can you tell us some reasons behind that meeting, why that took place? Was it only to update you with new information about the future from 2016 and 50 years on, or was there other reasons behind it?
Yeah. When I wrote the book, I got the information in regards to the future from 1974. forth in 2016. So we were looking for to know how it's going to be from now on and what we need to expect. So in September, we have a general meeting with all the groups in Brazil, and he came, as he promised, to give me an update in regards to what we're going to face from 2017 and so on. Unfortunately, the perspective is not good. But in some way or another, all the time we are under changes, transformations, and challenges for sure. And what he said was that for the next 40 years, planet Earth and the human beings are going to face an incredible challenge to survive. 2050, we're going to have a huge problem with water in our planet. Water is going to become a very tough commodity to be able to survive if we not do something in the middle. All these transformations in our society are going to jeopardize the balance of what we have been conquered for all these years. Our planet will need to be, our society will need to be extremely aware that we're going to also pay the price for the environment, and the climate change will we take, will we give us the bill for what we have been doing all these years? Storms, earthquakes and volcanoes, things like that, they're going to start to show their power more and more for the next 50 years. And if we're not able to control, or in this case, handle our civilization, our industrialization, and everything, the next 50 years, there are going to be a decision if the human race will be able to go or will die, basically. So we have 50 years. 50 years to define to what direction we're going to go. Thank you.